There's a tremendous amount of information available on how to stay healthy and live a fulfilling life. Don't put it off. Do it now. When we get older, we want to feel wonderful so we can continue to experience new adventures. And it's all within our reach, starting this very moment. I read something a while ago that intrigued me. It was an article about a San Francisco medical school that discovered the way we age is not determined by genes, but by something they call the aging set point, a biological time clock that exists in our minds. This mechanism actually monitors when and how we begin to age. The set point or aging clock is regulated in great part by one important factor: our attitudes towards getting old. For instance, if you believe that 35 is middle-aged, that belief triggers biological changes in your body that cause it to accelerate the aging process when you reach 35. Isn't that fascinating? Somewhere, somehow, we decide what is middle age and what is old age. Where are you setting that aging set point within you? I have this image in my mind that I'm going to live to be 96 years and still be active, so it's very important that I keep myself healthy. Remember too, what we give out, we get back. Be aware of how you treat older people, because when you get old, that will be the way you are treated. If you believe certain concepts about old people, again, you are forming ideas that your subconscious will respond to. Our beliefs, our thoughts, our concepts about life and about ourselves always become true for us. I believe that you choose your parents before you were born in order to learn valuable lessons. Your higher self knew the experiences that were necessary for you to proceed on your spiritual course. So whatever you came to work out with your parents, get on with it. No matter what they say or do or said or did, you are here ultimately to love yourself. As parents, allow your children to love themselves by giving them the space to feel safe and to express themselves in positive, harmless ways. Remember too, just as we choose our parents, our children also chose us. There are important lessons for all of us to work out. Parents who love themselves will find it easier to teach their children about self-love. When we feel good about ourselves, we can teach our children self-worth by example. The more we work on loving ourselves, the more our children will realize that it's an okay thing to do. When we get frightened, we want to control everything, and then we shut off the flow of good. Trust life. Everything we need is here for us. The power within us is willing to give us our fondest dreams and enormous plenty instantaneously. The problem is that we are not open to receiving it. If we want something, our higher power doesn't say, "I'll think about it." It readily responds and sends it through, but we have to be ready for it. If not, it goes back into the storehouse of unfulfilled desires. Many people come to my lectures and sit with their arms folded across their bodies, and I think, how are they going to let anything in? It's a wonderful symbolic gesture to open our arms wide so the universe notices and responds. For many, it's very scary, because if they open themselves up, they will think they may get terrible things, and they probably will, until they change whatever it is inside them that believes they will attract doom and gloom. When we use the term prosperity, a lot of people immediately think of money. However, there are many other concepts that come under the auspices of prosperity, such as time, love, success, comfort, beauty, knowledge, relationships, health, and of course money. If you are always feeling rushed because there isn't enough time to do everything you want, then you have a lack of time. You are poor in time. If you feel that success is beyond your reach, then you are not going to get it. If you feel life is burdensome and strenuous, then you will always feel uncomfortable. If you think you don't know very much and you're too dumb to figure things out, you will never feel connected to the wisdom of the universe. If you feel a lack of love and have poor relationships, then it will be difficult for you to attract love into your life. What about beauty, There is beauty all around us. Do you experience the beauty that is abundant on the planet, or do you see everything as ugly and wasteful and dirty? How is your health? Are you sick all the time? Do you catch colds easily? Do you get many aches and pains? And then there is money. Many of you tell me there is never enough money in your lives. What do you let yourself have? Or perhaps you feel you are on a fixed income. Who fixed it? None of the above has anything to do with receiving. People always think, oh, I want to get this and that and whatever. However, abundance and prosperity is about allowing yourself to accept. When you are not getting what you want, on some level, you are not allowing yourself to accept. If we are stingy with life, then life will be stingy with us. If we steal from life, life will steal from us. Being honest with ourselves. Honesty is a word we use a lot, not always understanding the true significance of what it means to be honest. It has nothing to do with morality or being a goody-goody. Being honest really has little to do with getting caught or going to jail. It is an act of love for ourselves. The main value of honesty is rooted in a simple truth. Whatever we give out in life, we will get back. This concept is based on the law of cause and effect, which is always at work in every aspect of our lives. It's like a universal rule that keeps everything in balance. Imagine this law as a mirror. What you put out into the world reflects back to you. If you belittle or judge others, then you, in turn, will be judged. It might not happen right away, but eventually, the negativity you spread will come back to you. This is why it's important to treat others with kindness and respect. When you judge someone harshly, you create an environment where judgment thrives. People around you might start judging you too, and you might find yourself in a cycle of negativity. The same goes for anger. If you are always angry, you will encounter anger wherever you go. It's like carrying a storm cloud with you. Your anger affects your interactions with others, making them more likely to respond with anger. You might find that people become defensive or hostile around you, reflecting the anger you project. This creates a loop of negative energy, where anger feeds more anger. On the other hand, the love we have for ourselves plays a crucial role in our lives. When we love ourselves, we stay connected with the love that life has for us. Self-love is like a foundation. It supports and nurtures us, allowing us to spread positivity. When we feel good about ourselves, we are more likely to treat others with kindness and compassion. This, in turn, attracts kindness and compassion back to us. For instance, imagine that your apartment has just been burglarized. Do you immediately think that you are a victim? My apartment was just ripped off. Who did this to me? It is a devastating feeling when something like that happens. However, do you stop to think of how and why you attracted the experience? Again, taking responsibility for creating our own experiences is not an idea that many of us want to accept all the time, perhaps just some of the time. It is so much easier to blame something outside of ourselves. Yet our spiritual growth cannot occur until we recognize that there is little of value outside of us. Everything comes from within. When I hear that someone has just been robbed or experienced some kind of loss, the first question I ask is, "Whom did you steal from lately?" If a curious look comes over their face, I know I have touched a tender spot. If we think back to a time when we took something and then think of what we lost shortly thereafter, the connection between the two experiences can be an eye-opener. When we take something that isn't ours, we almost always lose something of greater value. This isn't just a saying, it happens more often than we think. For example, if we take money or an object that doesn't belong to us, we might end up losing a relationship that is important to us. The loss may not happen right away, but eventually we pay a price. It's like the universe balances things out in its own way. Let's think about it in more detail. Imagine you take some money that isn't yours. At first, you might feel a sense of relief or excitement. You might think that no one will ever know and that it doesn't matter. But deep inside, something changes. You might start feeling guilty or worried about getting caught. This stress can affect your relationships. You might become more irritable or distant with people you care about, like friends or family. Over time, these small changes can add up, and before you know it, you could lose a friendship or damage a relationship with a family member. The money you took is gone, and so is something much more valuable. Now let's consider stealing a relationship. This might sound strange, but it can happen. Perhaps you pursue someone who is already in a committed relationship, thinking that you deserve to be with them instead. Even if you succeed in getting what you want, there might be consequences you didn't expect. The new relationship might cause you to lose your job because you're distracted or because your workplace finds out about your behavior. Your reputation could suffer, and this can make it harder to find another job. In the end, what you gained is far less than what you lost. Even small acts of taking things that aren't ours can have significant consequences. Imagine taking stamps or pens from the office. These items seem insignificant, but the act of taking them can set off a chain of negative events. You might feel a little guilty every time you use them, which can make you anxious or distracted. This anxiety can cause you to miss important things, like a train you needed to catch or a dinner date with someone special. These small missed opportunities can add up, causing you to lose more important things over time, like valuable time with loved ones or important work opportunities. It's unfortunate that many people steal from large companies, department stores, restaurants, hotels, and other businesses, thinking that these businesses can afford the loss. They might rationalize their actions by saying that taking a little won't hurt anyone. However, this type of rationalization doesn't work in the long run. The law of cause and effect is always at play. When we take something that isn't ours, it sets off a negative chain reaction, no matter how small the theft might seem. The universe keeps a perfect balance, and taking what isn't ours disrupts that balance. The principle is simple. If we take, we lose. But the opposite is also true. If we give, we get. This idea is a fundamental law of the universe. When we give freely, without expecting anything in return, we often receive in unexpected ways. For example, helping a friend in need might not give you a tangible reward right away, but it can strengthen your relationship and create a sense of trust and mutual support. This, in turn, can lead to other positive outcomes in your life, like receiving help when you need it most. If you think about it, the act of giving creates a positive cycle. When you give, you feel good about yourself, which boosts your mood and outlook on life. This positive energy attracts more good things into your life. People are more likely to help you, opportunities arise, and you find yourself surrounded by positive experiences and relationships. It's a natural law. The more we give, the more we receive. All the theories in the world are useless unless there is action, positive change, and finally healing. If we want to transform our lives, we must be willing to take the first step, even if it's a small one. Start by affirming to yourself every day that you are open and willing to receive the abundance of the universe. Open your arms wide, literally and figuratively, and welcome the good that is ready to flow into your life. You are the power in your world. You get to have whatever you choose to think. This is the best time to start right now. Make these minutes the best ones you'll ever spend by committing to change, to love, and to the endless possibilities that life offers. Love isn't just about being nice to others or giving hugs. It's much bigger than that. When we truly love, it's like we're unlocking a special door inside of us, one that leads to our very best selves. It's not selfish to love ourselves. In fact, it's the opposite. When we take care of ourselves and love ourselves no matter what, amazing things start to happen. Imagine your heart is like a magical treasure chest. Inside, there's all sorts of wonderful things waiting to burst out. Happiness, success, and feeling really good about who you are. When we love ourselves unconditionally, it's like we're opening up that treasure chest and letting all those good things flood into our lives. Think about it like this. When you're kind to yourself and treat yourself with love, it's like planting seeds in a garden. Those seeds grow into beautiful flowers that make your whole world brighter. You start to feel happier, more confident, and more at peace with yourself and the world around you. But it's not just about feeling good. It's also about attracting good things into our lives. When we love ourselves, we send out a signal to the universe that says, "Hey, I'm ready for good things to come my way." And you know what? The universe listens. It starts sending us all sorts of amazing opportunities and blessings because it knows we're open and ready to receive them. And here's the really cool part. When we're filled with love and positivity, it's contagious. It spreads to everyone around us, like ripples in a pond. Suddenly, our friends, family, and even strangers start feeling happier and more joyful too. It's like we're creating a ripple effect of love and goodness wherever we go. So how do we tap into this amazing power of love? It starts with simple acts of kindness and self-care. Take a moment each day to do something nice for yourself, whether it's taking a relaxing bath, going for a walk in nature, or simply giving yourself a pep talk in the mirror. Treat yourself with the same love and compassion you would give to your best friend. You see, love is the very fabric of the universe. It's the binding force that holds everything together. When we embrace love, we align ourselves with the infinite wisdom and abundance of the cosmos. Unfortunately, many of us place conditions on our love, waiting for external circumstances to change before we fully embrace ourselves. But my dear friends, the time for self-love is now. I believe that our planet is in need of love now more than ever. We are faced with challenges, yes, but these challenges are opportunities for us to open our hearts, to transcend our differences, and to come together in love and unity. We're living in a time where everything around us is changing, both for us individually and globally. It's like we're in the middle of a big dance where everyone has their own special moves. And guess what? We picked this exact time to be here. We chose to join in on all this excitement because we wanted to be part of making things better for ourselves and for the whole world. It's like we signed up for a big adventure, ready to spread love and bring peace to everyone and everything around us. You see, each of us has a role to play in this grand scheme of things. It's like we're all actors in a play, and the script is all about change and transformation. We're not just bystanders watching things happen. We're the ones making them happen. We're the heroes of our own stories, and together, we're creating a brighter future for everyone. So, why did we choose to be here at this moment? Well, it's because deep down, we knew we had something special to offer. We wanted to be part of this amazing time of change because we believed in the power of love and peace. We wanted to spread joy and make the world a better place for ourselves and for generations to come. Think about it like this. We're all like pieces of a puzzle, each one unique and important. And when we come together, we create something beautiful and whole. That's what we're doing right now, coming together to create a world filled with love, kindness, and understanding. Once upon a time, we used to think that someone or something outside of ourselves had all the answers. We looked to others to save us, to fix our problems, and to make everything better. But guess what? We've woken up to a big, beautiful truth. the power we've been searching for has been inside of us all along. It's like we've been living in a big fancy mansion, but we've only been exploring one tiny room. Now we're starting to realize that there's a whole world of possibilities waiting for us if we just step outside that room and explore the rest of the house. We're not just passive observers in this game of life. We're the ones holding the controller. We get to decide how the story unfolds, what adventures we go on, and how we overcome challenges along the way. We're like the architects of our own destiny, designing our lives exactly how we want them to be. It's kind of like being the captain of a ship. We're the ones steering the boat, charting our course, and navigating the waters ahead. Sure, there might be storms and rough seas along the way, but we have the power to steer through them and reach our destination. So, how do we tap into this amazing power within us? It starts with realizing that we are more than just our physical bodies. We're spiritual beings having a human experience with a spark of divinity inside of us that connects us to something greater than ourselves. When we tune into this inner wisdom, we start to see things differently. We realize that we have the power to create our own reality, to manifest our dreams, and to make our wildest fantasies come true. It's like having a magic wand that can turn our thoughts into reality, but with great power comes great responsibility. We have to be mindful of the thoughts we think, the words we speak, and the actions we take, because they all have the power to shape our reality. It's like planting seeds in a garden. If we want to grow beautiful flowers, we have to nourish the soil and tend to the plants with love and care. If you're not willing to love yourself today, then when? Tomorrow? Next year? My dear friends, today is the day to embrace yourself fully, without any expectations or conditions. Let us create a world where love knows no bounds, where we can express ourselves authentically and be accepted and loved for who we are. It all starts with self-love. The Bible tells us to love thy neighbor as thyself. But how often do we forget the last part, as thyself? We cannot truly love others until we first love ourselves. Self-love is the greatest gift we can give ourselves. When we love ourselves, we break free from the cycle of hurt and pain. Imagine your mind as a garden filled with beautiful flowers and lush greenery. But sometimes weeds creep in and block the sunlight, hindering the growth of the plants. These weeds represent the negative thoughts, resentments, and grudges that we hold on to from the past. They block the flow of positive energy and prevent us from experiencing true joy and peace. But just as a gardener tends to their garden, we can tend to our minds by practicing forgiveness. Forgiveness is like pulling out those weeds, allowing the sunlight of love and compassion to shine through once again. It's about releasing the grip of the past and making space for new growth and possibilities. When we forgive, we let go of the heavy burden that weighs us down. We release ourselves from the shackles of resentment and bitterness, allowing our minds to breathe freely once again. It's a powerful act of self-love and liberation. Forgiveness doesn't mean that we're excusing or forgetting what happened. It simply means that we're choosing to release the negative emotions that hold us captive. We're choosing to free ourselves from the past so that we can fully embrace the present moment. Forgiveness is like a magic key that unlocks the door to freedom. When we forgive, we set ourselves free from the chains of grudges and resentments. Holding on to anger and bitterness is like carrying a heavy sack of rocks on our backs. It weighs us down and makes it hard to walk forward in life. Think about it like this. When someone hurts us, it's natural to feel angry or upset. But if we hold on to that anger for too long, it becomes like a poison that spreads through our whole being, It fills us with negativity and eats away at our happiness and peace of mind. But when we choose to forgive, it's like releasing that poison and letting it evaporate into thin air. We no longer carry the weight of those hurtful feelings. Instead, we feel lighter and more at ease. We're able to stand tall and walk forward with a spring in our step. Forgiveness doesn't mean that we're saying what the other person did was okay. It doesn't mean that we're forgetting what happened or pretending it didn't hurt. Instead, forgiveness is a gift we give ourselves, a gift of peace, healing, and freedom. But when we choose to forgive, we release ourselves from the shackles of the past. We let go of the hurtful feelings and negative emotions that have been holding us back. We open ourselves to a new beginning filled with love, joy, and abundance. Now, you might be wondering, how do we actually practice forgiveness? Well, my dear ones, it's quite simple. We begin by making a deliberate choice to release the past and offer forgiveness to both ourselves and others for any hurt we believe they caused. Firstly, let's focus on forgiving ourselves. We all make mistakes, my darlings. It's a natural part of being human. But holding on to guilt and self-blame only weighs us down and prevents us from moving forward. So, take a moment to reflect on any mistakes or shortcomings you may have experienced. Then, with compassion and understanding, tell yourself, "I forgive you." Let go of any harsh judgments or criticisms you've been carrying and embrace yourself with love and acceptance. Next, let's turn our attention to forgiving others. This can sometimes feel more challenging, especially if we've been deeply hurt or wronged. But remember, forgiveness isn't about condoning or forgetting what someone did. It's about freeing ourselves from the burden of resentment and anger. So think about anyone who may have hurt or wronged you in the past. Take a deep breath and with an open heart say to them, either aloud or in your mind, "I forgive you." Release the grip of bitterness and allow compassion to flow in its place. A beneficial method to embrace forgiveness is through visualization. Let's try it together, my friends. Close your eyes and picture yourself enveloped in a comforting, radiant light. Feel the warmth and love emanating from this light, wrapping around you like a gentle embrace. Now, in this space of love and acceptance, imagine extending forgiveness to yourself and to others who may have caused you pain. See yourself releasing any grudges or resentments you've been holding on to, allowing them to dissolve into the light around you. Feel the heaviness of the past lifting off your shoulders, leaving you feeling lighter and freer. As you continue to visualize, envision yourself stepping forward into a future filled with brightness and peace. Picture yourself walking away from the shadows of resentment and anger towards a life filled with joy and serenity. See yourself surrounded by positivity and harmony as you embrace the present moment with an open heart. Feel the freedom that comes with forgiveness, my friends. Allow yourself to bask in the glow of this newfound liberation, knowing that you have the power to create a future unburdened by the pains of the past. Visualizing forgiveness in this way can be a powerful tool for transformation. It allows us to tap into the healing energy of love and compassion and to release the emotional baggage that weighs us down. By envisioning a brighter, more peaceful future, we plant the seeds for positive change in our lives. Another powerful tool is the use of affirmations. Repeat positive affirmations such as, "I am worthy of forgiveness and love," or "I release the past and embrace the present with an open heart." Affirmations can help reprogram your subconscious mind and reinforce your intention to forgive. We affirm to ourselves, "I am willing to free myself from the past. I forgive all those who may have harmed me, and I forgive myself for any harm I may have caused others. Then we visualize the painful experiences and emotions dissolving away, like a stream of water washing away all traces of negativity and resentment. When we choose to forgive and release the past, something wonderful happens inside us. It's like cleaning out a cluttered room and letting fresh air and light in. Forgiveness creates room for healing and change to happen in our lives. It's like planting seeds of love and kindness in a garden that was once overrun with weeds. When we let go of the hurt and anger that we've been holding on to, we make space for something beautiful to grow within us. It's as if we're making room for new positive energy to flow into our hearts and minds. This newfound openness allows us to receive all the good things that the universe has in store for us. Imagine your heart as a garden and forgiveness as the act of pulling out the weeds of resentment and bitterness. As you clear away the old unwanted growth, you create space for new seeds to take root and flourish. These seeds represent the abundance and blessings that the universe wants to shower upon you. With each act of forgiveness, you water these seeds with love and compassion. You nurture them with positive thoughts and